Hello, welcome back at the Bull Booth. Today we have two guests here. We have Bas Eickhout, who is member of the European Parliament for the Greens and working on climate change. And we have Hermann Ott, member of the German Parliament, and there he's the spokesperson for climate change. And Hermann has talked a lot lately about the climate policy of different speeds. So now what I would like to know from Bas is, what is your take on that proposal?
Well, what I think is really important is that Hermann is right, that's with the US it's not going to happen here or next year, so we need different speeds because it's very clear that the US will not be part of it. The big question is of course going to be how large will the coalition of the ones who want to go ahead, how large is it going to be? We know that Russia's difficult, Canada's difficult, but the big question is going to be what is China going to do? And related to that, what's India going to do? Because they don't want to be isolated only with US and Russia and these kind of countries. So therefore, China will play a pivotal role also here in Durban. And I think we will get this different speeds. The big question is, what is China going to do there?
Okay. Hermann, we're now in Durban and we have the climate talks here. Is there something like different speeds already happening here?
I can see a great dissatisfaction with the process. I mean, that is for sure. I mean, everybody is kind of annoyed with what's happening here. US is stalling again. US and China are fighting with each other. The EU is not visible. That's what's quite apparent. It's not visible. And that's why we have to change our strategy. And as Bas said, I mean, of course it's important who is with us. But there is an alliance possible of at least 150, 160 states, all the LDCs, most of the developing countries, and some of the emerging economies like South Africa, Brazil would be part of it, India probably not, but China, and you are right, China is a big player. There's immense geopolitical advantages also for China in such an alliance. Because the big fight, of course, is between the US and China. US is trying to restrict Chinese ascendance to power. And I think if the EU acts intelligently, it is possible to have an alliance here and isolate the US.
Okay, Bas, where do you see the potential of the European Union here in Durban?
Well, they play a very crucial role because they are the only group of developed countries who are willing to participate in this second commitment period of Kyoto Protocol, together maybe with Australia, New Zealand, but the EU is crucial there. The role they are playing now is vague, you're right, it's a strange role they are taking. I mean, what they do is like, well, we only do a step in Kyoto if other countries do a step in a binding deal. But now you see China, it's moving. For the first time they have said, well, we can imagine that after 2020 we take on board own targets. Now EU has to say, welcome this. China, what we do now is we commit ourselves to Kyoto Protocol period 2. And now together with China, get the deal on that roadmap for a binding deal. China is opening up a little bit. It is indeed a very tedious process, but it's opening up a little bit. India is a bit confused because China is moving a bit faster than India. And now it's the EU. They can decide to pull into China and get over here, isolate the US, and then India has to choose, are we going to stay over with the US or are we going to join China? And that is going to be an interesting dynamics that can happen, and Europe can play that role, but they really have to move now.
Okay. Hermann, the largest player in Europe is Germany, but the German Chancellor in her recent podcast was downplaying the role of Durban heavily. What should change and what should Minister Röttgen do here?
No, it is really a shame. I mean, this, if you give up on the result of negotiations before they have even started, really, in earnest term, then nobody takes you seriously anymore. And what Minister Röttgen now has to do is to make damn clear that Germany is going strong, that is decisive what Germany is doing. Whether Europe goes for the 30% target is dependent on Germany. It's not clear on that yet. And it would also kind of be for his own ambition. I think it would be great if he would stand up here and say, we can't go on like that anymore. We need progress. We need to see a good roadmap towards a binding treaty here. We need an extension of the Kyoto Protocol commitments. That is his role. And I can only hope that he will live up to this promise.
Thank you for being with us here in our booth in Durban, and let's hope that some actors at least will accelerate the speed for more progressive climate policy.
And hopefully Merkel will get a new speechwriter.
I hope so too.